Hi everyone, Bob is in the house. I'm fired up to do this video. I'm back. I'm finally back again. I'm sorry, I used the same phrase. I'm back again last week. I was back again, but look, when I don't do these videos, at least like for a few days, that's it, man. It feels like already that I've been not doing this for a long time and things like that. And also, I actually wanted to finish that run in last week with the reaction videos. I still didn't finish that run, meaning I was planning to do a reaction for Miley Cyrus because you guys you know, told me to do so, and you know, there were a few people asking me about Avicii as well, and Avicii, of course, it's from this week and we will do it for sure. But you know, like from the past, I still like, I'm kind of hoping that I will catch up on those releases. I haven't listened to Cardi B new song, even though I'm really interested. You know, Charlie XCX new tracks. There is more. There's much more. Chainsmokers and Bebe Rexha in songs like that. There has been a lot of new music, and I wasn't able to, you know, react on them on camera. But now we have Jonas Brothers, and I'm so excited about that because the first track, Sucker, was amazing. Cool. I'm feeling so cool. Top to the bottom, just cool. You know, yes, that's fucking dope. That song is amazing as well. Sucker is a 10 out of 10 song though, for sure. Let's just jump into it. The only one thing I have to say is actually I changed my mind on Katy Perry, Never Really Over. That song is a bop, actually. I mean, I said that I like it, but I said that it's just like, I mean, it's 7 out of 10 liking. It wasn't fantastic to me, but now it is fantastic. After much more listens, I actually enjoy that song really well, and I'm ready to give it a 9 out of 10. Plus, I said that Never Really Over is lower in quality than her older hits like Wide Awake, like Firework, Teenage Dream, and you know, songs like that. But no, actually this song is one of her better songs actually in a long time. So I'm amazed. I'm glad that I like it a lot, and I hope that Katy Perry will be on the high pedestal again. All right, Jonas Brothers, let's go. My computer declined my offer to work yesterday. So I'm filming this again, but I'm already tired of waiting. Let the happiness begin, goddammit. Track one, Sucker.
We go together.
You change the weather. Yeah. I'm a sucker for you. Track too cool.
I'm feeling so cool. Top to the bottom, just cool. Every little thing that I do. Damn it, I'm feeling so cool, cool, cool. Yeah. Nice summer last year.
Hey.
Standing lately, I've been feeling so cool. Top to the bottom, just cool. And I'm feeling so cool, 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 cool. Cause I do. And I'm feeling so cool, 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 cool.
Hey!
What's the gun, something right? Cause
I'm feeling like this.
When I get up, then I'm gonna let me go. I'm falling, lies if we made it. Lies if we're dying, but last year. Lady, I'm feeling so cool. Top to the bottom, just cool. And I love the thing I do. And I'm feeling so cool, 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 cool.
up.
I wanna be just like me, like the other guys. Cool, time to fight, just cool.
I went in real hard, didn't I? Ah, damn. I already can smell the copyright claim and demonetization for this video because I kept the cuts minimum. But fuck! The copyright claim. The art. What matters the most. Hey, look. I am so excited about this album. I know these two songs already, right? And they were hyping me up about this album so much. And you know, you probably already heard this album by yourself. I don't know it yet, but you know, if you know that it's fire, right? Don't expect me to jump on the bed today, because you know, even if I will have temptations like that, I cannot do it anymore, because sadly, my bed broke. Like, I mean, that part, like this, how do I call it? This area specifically, when I was like jumping here, there's like this one of the like sticks, one of the elements pretty much like broke down, and like now I cannot really perform like that over there. I'm scared. It's like bed is much lower than it used to, like in that area. Anyway, yeah, so, but I'm hoping that this album will deliver. These songs are great, these two tracks we heard, and I cannot wait. So get them all. Track 3, Only Human. Okay. I like it so far already. I like the tum, tum. I decided to point it out because, like, even though the main dish right now, in the production, there's like this additional tum. It's like making, like, it's delicious right now. It's gorgeously made. Yeah. Okay. Feels like it's Joe, right? Not Kevin. Also, sorry, like, for interrupting, like, this song is amazing, and I like how it's different already than the previous two tracks, but, like, when it comes to recognizing them by voices, I will be doing a terrible job, so I think I will just enjoy the music instead of, like, trying to recognize the members of the group. Right, come on. Don't be shy, just dance. Go to the dance floor. Dance your ass off. Nice. I like it. Yeah, fantastic. Track 4, I Believe. Ooh, slower jam. Damn. Oh, shit. Ooh! Hey. Yeah, I know what they say, and that will call me crazy. And people say that we move too fast. But you show me, it doesn't matter anymore. Now I got you here with me. Nothing matters any longer. Now I got you with me. I just was thinking, like, oh, I'm gonna cut the reaction significantly because I'm just sitting here and listening, and like there's no major reaction. But then, like, they changed it up, like, after 2 minutes, like, this sort of, like, they're entering the bridge or like different segment of the song, and then na 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 Like they spiced it up a little bit, and I appreciate that. Now it's like, oh shit, okay, there's more into this song. Okay, like it wasn't bad in the first place. I'm just saying, like, you know how those slow jams usually stay stale and steady. Here they actually making a progression, which is really nice. Damn. This is gonna be so cool. This song. Driving at night, in summer, driving at night. Nice. I'm loving it so far, having a great time. Track 5, used to be. Damn, they're slowing the album down, because after Cool and, you know, Sucker, I thought it's gonna be really like dancey album, like happy album. Just plus the title Happiness Begins, but you know, already second track where like we're sort of in our feelings when we're sort of like listening to our soul, soulful tracks, you know what I'm saying? Slowed down, slow jams. So interesting. How the album's gonna progress. Wow. Hey. Right. Baby, if it's what you want. Speed that talk, baby. Right. Damn, I'm really enjoying this. I actually am. Damn, this is amazing. Track 6 every single time. Hey, okay. Coming back to up tempo songs. Okay. Right. It's so groovy, I can't stop bopping my head around, you know? Nice, come on. It's so nice. It's a fucking good album so far, bro. I'm telling you. Single time. Nice! Oh shit. My light. Stay here, please. Track 7. Don't throw it away. Awesome. I just wanted to tell you that there were people throughout this 2 years, actually, I'm doing YouTube. Sometimes I do get comments like, hey, like, why are you cutting your reaction and things like that? You should like keep it in full. But like, imagine, especially with album reviews, if we kept it like full songs and like if we never cut, you know, it would be like hour long videos and nobody want to watch that. Plus, the actual reason, you know, the main reason why we music reactors cut the music is because copyright claims. If we never cut the songs, we would get demonetized, plus even usually blocked. You know, our videos would have been blocked. I remember, like, if you stick with me from the beginning of this channel, my channel was shut down even one time, because you know, I got 3 strikes, and that means that, you know, you can no longer operate your channel. I had to, like, fight for it back. I was fighting for it for 1 month. Like, I was, like, emailing people, hey, look, like, I think it's not that fair, and things like that. I had to prove people things. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, I understand your complaint, but at the same time, I cannot keep the full song, keep the full reaction. It was on my mind, that's why I'm expressing, like, no correlation to Jonas Brothers specifically or something like that. I'm just telling you, because, like, recently I got another comment like this, and it's like, I'm surprised, because, like, why are you guys, like, commenting this, like, especially, like, to me? Because other music reactors do it as well. Like, if I understood, like, if everybody else but me, like, had, you know, full song on and, like, they were listening to it. But no, like, everybody tries to avoid that headache, copyright claim headaches. That's why they're cutting it, you know what I'm saying? Anyway, just food for talk. And now, to sort of transition to something more positive, I brought banana. I just randomly brought banana. It's a symbol of our summer. It's gonna be a symbol of our summer, because, like, it's a nice fruit, you know what I'm saying? It's yellow, just like Music with Bob channel. You know, his main color is yellow, so I should have taken off, you know, things that I'm keeping my braces on, but it's fine. I can eat it with it. And, like, this would have been sexier if it was a girl. But I'm the man who eat banana and proud of it. Eat bananas, you won't regret it. Track 8, Love Her. Really nice instrumental, really good lyrics as well. One of my favorite tracks so far. Sorry, just when he said, when you love her, it's like Ed Sheeran freaking influence. This is like 100% Ed Sheeran. God damn it. Damn. Oh. She's always right, and that's all right. I guess it's okay if they're similar. Yeah, this is like Ed Sheeran. 100%. Right. Nice. Cause when you love her, no matter the fight, you know they say love can hurt, but seeing a smile will get hurt. La 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 la. Yeah. Because you. Great. Fantastic song. Amazed by it. Track 9. What do I have next? Happy. Happy when I'm sad. Oh. Interesting choice in production. Okay. Okay. Well, this was one of the few songs I was like, okay, this is not bad, but it's like not fantastic. I would say track 7 and track 9 are my least favorite songs so far. But the album overall is still delivering, it's still a fantastic album. Track 10, Trust. Okay, the groove, and then the voice.
Come on, come on.
Nice. I love the fact that they went to a different route on this track. They chose alternative vibe. You know, they had like light rock sort of into, you know, light rock is pretty much alternative. Alternative might be different though, but like if you remember about Red Hot Chili Peppers, for example, Green Day, you know, there you will not call it rock, you know, but it's like sort of light rock because you still have those guitars and drums, and still you have that groove, you know, a specific groove that is close to rock. So that's why it's alternative, and like this, they had it here, and I really appreciate that. I really liked it, really enjoyed it, and yeah, I mean, let's go to the next track, and we'll talk about lyrics like by the end when we will listen to all of the tracks. All right, track 11, Strangers. Oh, this instrumental reminds me of Coldplay, actually. Nice, nice song. I like the line which he said, so that I will not forget. What line is it? You know, it was like when he said, I'm always trying to escape from something beautiful. That's kind of pretty, like, that is relatable. That is relatable, because I myself, like, with hesitating, hey, look, like, if I commit to this thing, for example, will it be worth it? Well, do I need it right now? Do I need to, if I commit and, like, then decide to pull away, like, I might hurt this person for no reason, and, you know, I don't want to hurt nobody, you know, at least intentionally, you know what I'm saying, like, because you will end up hurting anyone no matter what, you know, and I did it before, for sure, so, like, I mean, I'm not proud of it, but, you know, it happens, you know, it's life. What I'm saying is, especially, like, this year, last year, like, this few last years, I'm like really careful, like, with what I'm doing in my life, I guess, and with what kind of relationships I'm going forward. But sometimes it feels like, hey, this relationship might be actually really awesome, or not. It's not even like relationship specifically, but anything. Maybe new class, new hobby, you know, new people, and that might be something beautiful if you will start that, like, new idea, new business, I don't know, something like that. Maybe it is something beautiful, and it will work out for the better, you know, if we will step it forward. It might be your best thing in your life, but you're kind of sort of afraid to step in. Let me tell you something, don't hesitate to jump in. I know I said that I don't really jump in, but, like, it is true. But at the same time, I believe that you should step in. You should get that opportunity when you have it, rather than, oh, what if I didn't, you know what I'm saying? So definitely jump into opportunity. Don't be like me. Alright. Alright, track 12, we have Hesitate. Oh, hesitation, we were talking about hesitation, now it's track 12, Hesitate. Alright, let's do it.
Kiss the tears right off your face.
Wait, is it Shawn Mendes?
Yeah, that's the old me.
His voice was really similar to Shawn Mendes right now. And even the instrumentation.
The only is if we work through it now. Just tell me where to say.
Damn, that song was incredible. The subject matter is touching, but what is most fantastic about the song is the delivery, the musicality of it, how these emotions were portrayed, how musically they delivered that. It was really touching, heartfelt. Song was incredible. I really appreciate that. One of the favorite tracks on here for me as well. Bro, damn. Got me in my feelings. I actually, in a situation where, you know, I have one girl for which I won't hesitate to do anything as well. So it's definitely relatable, and yeah, I saw myself in this track. Track 13, Roller Coaster.
It was fun when we were going and never
older. Bro, they keep delivering. Damn. Nice. Yes. Hey, happiness begins. Track 14, Come Back, last song of the album. Come on, let's get it. Oh, damn. We're gonna close it with a hard ballad that is difficult to process for the heart.
Come back to me, baby, I'll come back to you.
I'm gonna end up crying. Female fans, gonna faint. Damn. Hold on. Yo, I felt that this, sorry, like before this song actually started, like when there was just like simple piano, like the guy, maybe Joe or Nick was singing, like it was truly magical, breathtaking. You know, his performance was really beautiful, and the song is still going, of course. Very emotional. Very nice. Hey! Yes. The girl, I'm ready to do anything for you. Where are you? If you come back, I will come back to you too. God damn it. Don't want to say her name. Yes. Yes, yes, like AJ says, they did what? That. They did what? That. They did that. They literally destroyed the fucking universe with this fucking last track, bro. God damn, the closure of the album is so strong. One of the favorite tracks again. God damn it, that song was fire, bro. It's so good. I can't believe how good it is, actually. Oh my god, bro. Whew. What just happened? What did just happen? How? How? Oh man, no, I'm not gonna cry. Hold on, I'm not gonna cry. Hold on. No. I'm stopping it. Alright, look. Bro, I'm crying how, like, because how good this album is. I was planning to give this album 8 out of 10, like, throughout, when I was listening to the songs, and, like, I would say this idea of giving 8 out of 10 came when I was listening to track 8 or 9, you know, like around that time. It's like, okay, like probably I will end up giving it 8, but now, like this last, like, 4 tracks, bro. Strangers, Hesitate, Roller Coaster, Come Back, bro. Like, one is better than the other, and it's like, it was going up, and it's like, ended on the fucking pedestal, and high. It's like, it's Zeus, the god of Greece. He stood up, like, he climbed the mountain. It's like, this is my spot. I am freaking on the top. Nobody is gonna doubt that. You know what I'm saying? It's like, they sort of killed it. They nailed it at the end. It's like, now, looking back, even if there are like a couple songs I was like, okay, not that fantastic, not that good, now it's like they make me doubt to give an 8 and instead of giving a 9. You know what I'm saying? It's like, god damn it, this pop album is freaking fantastic. And the reason why I mentioned pop is because another thought of mine I had, we're going to talk about lyrics. The lyrics on the album wasn't that witty. It was not clever. It's just pretty generic. Okay, I wouldn't say well, it's the topics that you would tackle on the pop album, right? It's pretty standard. The topics were standard, you know what I'm saying? For my taste, at least. Sucker and Cool, they had still probably one of the most cool lyrics. For me personally, like Tattooed Inside My Brain, for example, from Sucker, or like I'm Feeling So Cool, Top to the Bottom, just cool. It's like they had their unique sort of flavor, because I haven't really listened to a song where it's like actually just about being cool, for example, you know, track Cool, or Sucker. You know, the references they did, they were clever, they were witty, like about how you love somebody, like thinking about it all the time and things like that. You know, that's how it was tattooed in the brain. There were a couple, there were much more lyrics. I'm just, for some reason, I'm focusing on the Tattoo Inside My Brain lyrics, that's the only lyric I can remember right now for some reason. But believe me, there is more. And I love those tracks. Other songs though, like I said, they were pretty standard. Yes, like about, you know, love or Happy When I'm Sad, for example. Happy When I'm Sad had a good topic to talk about. It's pretty relatable when you like you give that smile, even if you're not happy actually inside, when you're actually sad, you know. But I don't really remember like they were tackling this topic really well. When it comes to wit, it wasn't witty, you know what I'm saying? For example, Ariana Grande with Fake Smile tackled this topic much more passionate, much more clever, with more wit, right? And it was just phenomenal for me personally. That like she tackled this topic much better than Jonas Brothers tackled this topic, you know, at least for my taste, at least. So that's why I'm talking about the lyrics. They weren't as striking, but you know, it doesn't mean it wasn't relatable. They were, of course, a human experience. Of course, it's gonna be relatable. But the question is, how did they approach songs lyrically? And that's why I was like, oh, like, it's pretty standard. Not enough wit. But the reason I mentioned term pop album is because other pop albums have it too, and I'm okay with that. You know what I'm saying? The reason why I'm not judging Jonas Brothers for like they could have done better in terms of lyrics, because it's a pop album. You know, you do have a sort of pass when, you know, you're not coming with the best lyrics in the world. You know what I'm saying? As long as it sounds good, you know, as long as it makes you some type of way, it is already enough. I don't want to like lower my rating just because, you know, lyrics weren't something like mind-blowing. You know, they were still there, is what I'm saying. It just wasn't mind blowing, but I'm fine with that. But I'm not sure if you are fine with that. What struck me the most, what surprised me, and made me so obsessed with this album is the delivery, the musicality of the album. How did they portray those feelings they tried to portray with their words? Musically, it just came together. The production was tasty, a lot of different instruments, genres even sometimes. I really appreciate this album. Happiness Begins, bro. I would say 8.5 out of 10 for me. It's a good album. I didn't find a single bad track. Single track where I was like, oh, I want to skip it. I still listen to all of them, still enjoy them all. It's just like track 7 and track 9, when I was listening to them specifically today, this reaction, it was like maybe a little bit less enjoyment out of this than other tracks, but still, all tracks were great. I mean, I liked them. I definitely liked them. All right, hit the like button if you like this video, subscribe to this channel, let me know what you want me to react next, and I'll see you guys in the next ones. Don't forget to click the bell to not miss videos when I upload them. All right, thank you for watching. Goodbye.